Even since the Ura surrendered to us, the Marshals kept a wary eye on him. Marshals kept the city's peace. They can rest easy now. The trappers, daring bunch of fools, they'll be missed. Zolf's travels ain't much compared to what the kids had to go through for all this. Behold. Ever felt a Zolwood gourd like picking up broken glass barehanded? At Zolwood Grove, Marshals learn to make every shot count. The trick was to pop all those nasty gourds without wasting ammo. Most Marshals didn't get far on their first few tries. Catch a bunch of those gourds in a single shot. Funny thing about muskets is they work best up close. It took a keen eye, not an itchy trigger finger. Marshals did more than just stand around shooting, of course. The Marshals learned to pack those shells full of fire. The Langston River flowed free and wild till the Calamity drank it all up. Maybe all that water just grew wings and flew off. Riverbanks swarming with windbags. They're so bent on finding the core, they hardly notice the kid. Lucky for him, a certain famous ferry barge is still afloat. She sends some squirts crying home as she leaves port. Maybe Nelly knows the way to the core. Maybe she can slip right past all the clamor on the coast. Or maybe not. A security skiff pulls up portside. Nelly's just another windbag to those guns. Just then, the windbags notice who she's sailing with. They're pretty steamed about what happened at Cinderbrick. They try to cut her off. They try to slow her down. They try to knock her out. Well, Weepin' Nelly tries harder. Try as she might, though, she hits a snag. Kid's gotta help her get untangled. Favors for favors. She picked a good spot for a break, because the core's right there. Then the kid hears an unusual sound, like 100 flapping wings. Peckers. They've been watching his every move. They have their own eyes on the core, but why? Well, kid ain't got time to think it over just yet. He finds Weepin' Nelly raring to go. Turns out she's got a special surprise for when the water's getting rough. She's gonna need a little help with all them peckers. Crafty things think they're king of the roost now. Rest of us only wish we could fly in times like these. Securitas gifts keep off coming, Starman sighed. Don't seem to care what they shoot, as long as they hit something. Seems a calamity ain't hurt the peckers' appetites. Might be they want it just as bad as a kid. Kid shoos them off, knowing they'll be back. Know how many times kid nearly fell off the barge back there? Not even once. Listen close. You should remember this next part. Why go to Prosper Bluff? Used to take an enterprising man or a plain old fool to venture out that far. The city was the most beautiful place in the world. We all knew that. But on the other hand, some folks just yearn to see the things they're told they can't. And that's why you go to Prosper Bluff, ain't it? The kid hears something he ain't heard in a long while. How's it go again? Yeah, that's the one.
Build that city.
Well, no point explaining what happens next, right? Suffice it to say, the kid ain't coming home empty-handed. And besides, it's like the song goes. They'll be here before too long. Darn near celebrated when the kid got back, didn't we? Zolf never thought he'd see a fellow Ura again. We become fast friends. Calamity has that effect on people. But there was more to be done. There was one last core to find.